like your Stand By Me song. Just, you know, I'm gonna go out there. And, oh, you're not looking for me, right? You're looking for Osiris. Well, here's the thing is, Osiris is, and then if you could just come in. Royce.
When the night has come in the land is done. Is done. Gabriel, oh, I thought you were here to see me. Oh man. Well, let me tell you, we got a great opportunity. Here it is, from New York. His name, Osiris. Osiris. Oh wait. What you don't realize that Osiris is
Royce.
So basically, I'm here to talk to you guys for a little while just about music, Spanish, drugs, education, a little bit of whatever you guys want to talk about. So for the people that don't know me, they call me Prince Royce. I sing bachata. Now, if you don't know what bachata is, bachata originated in the Dominican Republic. It was a rhythm. It was actually a kind of a low-class rhythm that nobody really wanted to play in the clubs. Nobody wanted to play in the radio stations. And it's been growing. And a guy named Anthony Santos was the one that kind of got it commercial. So they started playing it in the clubs. Started getting radio play. A group called Aventura came along, and they took it a little more mainstream. They broke it into countries like Chile, Ecuador, all over South America, Europe. Now I came along. I'm 21 years old right now. I grew up in the Bronx. I grew up in New York. My parents are Dominican. New York in the house. I grew up in a kind of a tough neighborhood in the Bronx. I grew up in a neighborhood where there were a lot of drugs, there was a lot of violence, and I chose a different route. I chose not to go with what my friends were doing because it was cool or because it was in. And you know, it's funny because when you're growing up, you know, they tell you, you know, try weed or do this and do E, and you're not gonna get addicted, and I can stop whenever I want. But the reality is that you can't stop whenever you want. And so I chose a different route. I grew up in a small family. It was my mother, my father, and my older brother, my little sister, and my little brother. And it was always really close. So, you know, my mom always just tell me, you know, stop hanging out in the street and stop going to this party. And I kind of used to get upset, but now I look back and I'm actually thankful that they used to keep me home. I used to stay home and just play video games all day. That was really my way of just getting away from all the negative stuff. So that's what I did. I stayed home, I wrote music, I wrote songs. Later on, I started recording music at 15. That's when I started experimenting with pop and R&B and a lot of different rhythms. And I graduated from high school. I was attending college to be a literature teacher. I always wanted to be a teacher because I said that I always wanted to be an impact to kids. And I said that, you know, my way of being an impact to kids was through music. And if my music didn't work out, I wanted to be a teacher. So I was studying to be a literature teacher, reading a lot of books, writing a lot of essays, and I was also working for a cell phone company. I was working for a cell phone company, selling phones in the Bronx, uptown. So I would go to work at 8 in the morning. I would finish at 7 p.m. full time. I would, after work, I would go to school in my I used to work for Sprint, in my Sprint uniform. And I would get out of school probably like at 10 or 11, and the school was a little far. It was like an hour away from home. So after that, I would go to the studio. I would go to the studio with the money that I made at the job. I would invest it in the music, and I spent about $6,000 or $7,000 recording my demo. So a lot of people used to tell me, "You're crazy. You're crazy for spending all this money and something that you don't know if it's really gonna work out, and something that you don't know if it's gonna happen." But I took the risk, and that's what life is about. You gotta take risk, and you gotta believe in yourself, you know? If you don't believe in yourself, no one will, you know? That's something I always told myself. If I don't believe in myself, who will? Because there's always gonna be people that put you down. There were a lot of record labels that closed doors on me. There were a lot of people that said that there was nothing different about me, that I'm just a regular kid that can't sing, you know? So you just gotta believe in yourself, for real. I'm telling you the truth. I'm not even like up here trying to find you. I finished my demo, I took it to a lot of places, and then, you know, that's when later on I signed with Sergio George, who's a producer that he's produced for Mark Anthony, Seth Blues, and other people. And that's when I recorded the album. I started with Stand By Me, it was a cover. You know, you all know 1961, came out in 1961. I brought it back in Bachata with a little bit of Spanish. And then I wrote Corazón Sin Cara on my way to the train. I wrote Corazón Sin Cara on my way on the train to school, to college. And Corazón Sin Cara is a song that talks about self-esteem, and talks about you know, it doesn't matter if you're a little fat, or if you're skinny, or if you're white, or if you're black, or if you're always, you know, stuck with the makeup. I noticed that a lot of girls nowadays, especially the girls, guys too, but especially the girls, girls are always, you know, self-conscious about themselves and always worried about what they look like and what they're wearing, and dudes nowadays are always worried about what new Jordans they got on. And it's not about that. It's not about the materialistic stuff. It's not about like what you got on, and true love and real love. What matters is the personality and the heart. So that's what the song's about. And, you know, last year I was just a regular kid in the Bronx with a small dream, and now dreams are coming true, and that's what I'm here to talk to you guys about, to let you know that dreams do come true, and you gotta believe in yourself. You gotta believe in yourself, and you gotta finish school. School's important, you know. If you wanna be an actor, if you wanna be a singer, keep doing school and keep just doing music on the side. If music turns out good, then I mean, I wanna go back to school too. Right? The only reason why I can't is because all the travel and real stuff. Spin it! Okay, there you go. So this is Corazón Sin Cara. It's mostly in Spanish, but like I said.
Hey, sing along with me.
You know, being bilingual is important. I encourage all of you to keep on learning Spanish. It got me my job. It got me the job that later on paid for my demo. So being bilingual really helps out, and learn as much as you can. You gotta learn every day. And you learn as many languages as you can. It's always good.
What do you say? Once again, Detroit! I wanted to say thanks for the love, thanks for the support. Really appreciate it. And I love you all. Thank you.